Friends say before the shooting, the victim told them the man who was detained was behaving oddly. However, no one imagined things would go in this direction.
She was always 10 toes down.
A piece of me left when my little sister left, for real. Couldn't do nothing but cry.
They don't know when they take a loved one, they don't know how much it really hurt to lose my only daughter.
Around 11:45 a.m. on June 30th, the Shelby County Sheriff's Office responded to a shooting on Crosswood Lane near Cross Hill Drive in the Cordova area of South Memphis. Upon arrival, they would find a woman suffering from gunshot wounds.
Memphis police officers flood Oaken Bucket Drive in Cordova overnight. Investigators say a woman was shot and killed inside this home.
It was shocking to come outside and see it because there's something we don't have in this neighborhood often.
The victim's family and friends stand on the sidelines embracing each other as officers carry out the investigation.
People who live in the area tell me they heard several gunshots shortly after 11 o'clock last night. Neighbors say the victim lived in the house for years, and they say they are heartbroken to learn that one of their very own community members was killed.
She was very friendly. She used to walk her dogs around, speak to everybody. You know, everybody knew her. Very good person at heart.
Neighbors say they heard some sort of argument right before the shooting.
The Shelby County Sheriff's Office said a woman was rushed to Regional 1 Hospital in critical condition, but later succumbed to her injuries. Detectives identified her as 28-year-old Marquicha Thomas, a young mother to 8 beautiful children. The Sheriff's Office stated that initial information suggests the shooting stemmed from domestic violence. Detectives later found out that Marquicha and her boyfriend, 33-year-old Byron Pipkin, got into an argument at the home. Court documents state that one witness saw Byron shoot Marquicha as she tried to run out of the garage. When Marquicha collapsed in the front yard, Byron dragged her back into the garage before going into the home and telling a 6-year-old girl to come with him. Byron then reportedly fled the scene with the 6-year-old girl. Police said Byron then called 911 and told operators he was following the person who shot his girlfriend. He allegedly claimed that another man was the shooter during the 911 call, but officers later determined that Byron was the shooter. Officers also said Byron dropped off the 6-year-old girl at an acquaintance's home before leaving the area. He was found one day after the shooting at the Economy Inn on Ketchum Road after police received a tip on his whereabouts. The sheriff's office said Byron barricaded himself and refused to come out of the room after they gave verbal commands. His loved ones also showed up to assist investigators. Roughly 2 hours later, Byron walked out of the room and was taken into police custody. A closer look into Byron's past will reveal that he was previously convicted for aggravated assault in 2012.
Breaking right now, we now know the name of one person in custody after a standoff with deputies in South Memphis. Shelby County Sheriff's Office told us this man, 33-year-old Byron Pipkin, has been arrested and charged with first-degree murder and other charges. And we are told he was wanted in connection to a deadly shooting yesterday on Crosswood Lane in Cordova. Deputies tracked him down to the Economy Inn on Ketchum Road at Airways Boulevard, where he barricaded himself inside one of the hotel rooms, and that lasted for about an hour. Deputies say the barricade situation ended peacefully, and Pipkin was detained.
Loved ones met just off the banks of the Mississippi River to remember the woman they say was a bright light to everyone she came across.
They don't know. When they take a loved one, they don't know how much it really hurt to lose my only daughter I had.
Prior to Marcus Briscoe's child being taken away, he says the warning signs were there and his deepest fear came true last week.
I had told her, I said, if a man beating on you and pulling guns on you, sooner or later, he gonna kill you and I'm gonna have to bury you. And it went just like I said. If he fighting you, pulling guns on you, get out the relationship, because sooner or later, like I told my daughter, he is gonna kill you.
Despite what led up to her death, loved ones are choosing to remember her as the light in which she was.
It's about the kids, and I just want everybody to stay in good spirits and, you know, love everybody while they're here.
He has been charged with first-degree murder, convicted felon in possession of a handgun, domestic assault, bodily harm, and existing warrants. He's expected to appear in court on July 5th.